text messages, other private data from Android phone users without their knowledge. Roger McNamee is co-founder of Elevation Partners. He was an early investor in Facebook and a mentor to Mark Zuckerberg. He's now a sometime critic of the company. He joins us tonight. Roger, thanks for coming on.
Happy to be here, Tucker.
So, my one-sentence take on this is it seems like the rest of the country is waking up to the basic nature of Facebook, which is it spies on you.
No, I think that the issue is exactly as you framed it. The business model, which is based on advertising, requires them to know as much as they can about every single user. And what you don't know and what you can't tell as a user is that they are using every tool available. And Android phones, as Ars Technica pointed out, have a feature that allows a product like Facebook to download all of your contacts, all of your texts, and Facebook goes, well, someday we may be able to monetize that. We're just going to grab it while it's there. And a lot of people discover to their chagrin that it's not just Cambridge Analytica. In fact, from 2010 to 2014, there were at least tens of thousands and maybe hundreds of thousands of applications that did the same thing. They harvested all of the user data that was out there without the permission of the users.
So, that information, those data, give Facebook more power over you than, for example, any government's ever had over American citizens. Should we be worried about that power?
Well, I believe that that's the kind of power that requires great judgment. And the thing that we've seen in recent months is that Facebook's judgment around its power has been really poor. And I personally, as somebody who mentored them, who was involved as an investor, who was at one time extraordinarily proud of it, my tenure there, which was from 2006 to 2009, was before the company had really developed a business model. And so I was withdrawn while this stuff was going on. And as I came to understand what was going on, I felt it was important to reach out to Mark Zuckerberg and Sheryl Sandberg and make them aware of it, which I did in 2016. And it's hard when you're in the position they're in to recognize that your baby has suddenly become a huge problem. But I'm afraid it has. And candidly, I'm glad these revelations are coming out because we need them to change their strategy.
So Android users found out that they're being spied on by Facebook. Do you think we're going to learn that Apple users are being spied on as well?
No, Apple has a different architecture, so I think that probably not. I think the sad thing is we're going to discover if you're an Android user, it's not just Facebook who's spying on you.
Right.
The difference is in Apple's model, because the people pay directly to Apple when they buy the phone, Apple treats those people as the customer. With Android, it's the phone company that's the customer. And so just as in Facebook, where the advertiser is the customer and the user is the product, the user of the phone to Android is also a product. And that's the problem with the model. It's that they aren't treating us like humans. They're treating us like the fuel to generate profits. And candidly, I think that has to stop. I think all of Silicon Valley needs to reassess why it's in business and recognize that they can be incredibly profitable. They can still be billionaires without stripping the privacy from everybody and selling it to the highest bidder.
It took 40 years for the government to respond to the health effects of tobacco, which weren't recognized at first. People, it slowly dawned on people, and then the government took action. How long will it take our government to respond to the bad effects on our society of Facebook and Google?
Well, to be clear, Tucker, I don't think the best response will be the one from the government. I think the best response will be from the users and from the employees of these companies. Huh. I don't think the employees understood exactly what the companies were doing. And I think as they understand it, they're going to appreciate that, wait a minute, that is not something they want to be part of. And I think you're going to see some kind of pushback and rebellion. One of the things we've been trying to encourage the employees of Facebook and some of these other companies to do is to recognize that, hey, wait a minute. These are great ideas. These companies make great products, but the advertising business model has terrible incentives, and literally billions of people are being hurt by it, not just in the U.S., but around the world. And that, frankly, they can be successful without doing that stuff, and it's on the employees to fix it, because let's face it, the government is not going to be able to fix this on a time frame that's going to make any difference.
No. Well, that's a good point. They're not even trying. I hope that happens.
Well,
Roger, thank you for that. We're out of time, but I appreciate
my pleasure, Tucker.
Your knowledge and your candor. Up next, Professor Jordan Peterson is questioning the modern left's core assumptions about gender and a lot of other things. And for that crime, they have decided he must be annihilated. Jordan Peterson joins us next. Stay tuned.
Hi, I'm Mike Ditka. You know, you don't get to be a Hall of Fame player without taking